Today we're going to talk about how to install the A4988 on a Roomba board. Now on the Roomba board, I got to show you a couple of things here. We have our X stepper ports, our Y stepper ports, our Z stepper ports, our E0 stepper ports, our E1 stepper ports, and our E2 stepper ports. So these are all for the extruder. Now over here we have our jumpers. They're actually dip switches. So I believe they're all in the on position because they labeled the on right here. So the next thing that we need to do is figure out where the ground is. And for that, I'll show you what the PCB tracing looks like in just a second. Okay, now that we know where the steppers are for X, Y, Z, and so on and so forth on the Roomba board, we're going to look at the PCB for a second and see where the ground pins are. So as you can see, there's a very strange drawing here where you've got four dashes around it. That means that it's grounded, and then the other ground is up here. That will be the same for all of the pins for the steppers. So those are our ground pins. So in a moment, I'll show you on the underside of the A4988 where the ground pins are. Okay, now that we know where the ground is in the PCB tracing, we're going to look at where our pins are. So as you can see, on the underside of the A4988, we have our direction pin here and our ground pin here. And when I was talking about the second ground, now we know how they line up. So I marked the corner on the board, which I'll show you in a moment. Okay, now that we know that the ground is this pin and the pin up here, what we're gonna do is we're going to align those pins on the bottom of the A4988. So to do that, we're gonna take it, and we know that the ground is here, so we're gonna rotate it over, and then we're gonna place it on the board. Apply a little bit of thumb pressure to get it into place. And then the other thing that we need to do is connect our DuPont connector for our stepper for the NEMA 17. Now keep in mind that there's also screw down blocks that we can use to connect these wires as well over here for each one of the steppers. So the next step is to connect the USB to the computer in order to set up the Marlin firmware on the computer. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the cable connector and we're going to connect it to the board over here. We're going to slide that in and we're going to connect the other end of the computer, and you'll hear a beep in a moment. And in a second, we'll install the Marlin firmware. Okay, the first thing that we want to do is we want to open up the Marlin-bugfix-1.1.9. Inside here, we want to open up the Marlin subfolder, and we want to open up boards. Now, inside boards, I have highlighted board_Roomba. We're going to copy that and we're going to close out of there. And then we're going to press M on the keyboard and we're going to open up the marlin.ino file. Now we're going to go to the configuration.h tab and we're going to search on motherboard. And what we currently have is board_ramps_14_EFB. We're going to paste what we copied out of the boards file right here. Next thing that we want to do is we want to check for our steps. So I have to search for this. So what we have here is default
axis steps per unit. For the A4988, these are default, so we don't have to worry about changing anything. So it's going to be default 80 steps for X, Y, and then Z is going to be 4000, and then the extruder is going to be 500. Now keep in mind that configurations can vary, so you might have to go to the RepRap calculator to figure out what you have and what your steps will need to be. The other thing that you want to consider is if you're using mixed steppers now, in the Marlin firmware for 1.1.9 bug fix, there's something new. So TMC2130 is how we're going to search for it. And what we have here is the option to specify your drivers. But seeing how we're using the A4988, we don't have to because it's assumed that that's what the drivers are. But if you were to mix them like with the DRV8825 for, let's say, the Y, then you would have to remove the comment. You would then have to basically type this in, or in this case, copy and paste. And that would be your second driver. So that's true for everything except for the A4988. And then if you want to be on the safe side, you could always remove the comment so that you're specifying what you're talking about. But in this case, we don't need to worry about it. So all we have to do is compile and upload. So we're going to go over to Tools. We're going to see what port we need to select. In this case, it looks like port 7 or COM7. And then we have to check to make sure that we have the right board chipset selected. And because this uses a Mega 2560, we're going to go with that. So the next thing that we need to do is press the Compile and Upload button. And this will compile the code and then upload it to the Roomba 3D printer board. So in a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how we can test it.
Okay, off camera, I connected the power for the board in the power section over here. So this board is energized right now, so you should not touch it. The only thing it's safe to touch is the end stop over here. In a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how we can test it.
Okay, the first thing that we want to do is we want to open up Pronterface. We then want to connect to the Roomba board. Now, let's test real quick if we can move 10 forward, which we can. Now, in order to move back and forth, we have to home. So I'm going to press the home button and actuate the end stop. So now I'm going to move forward 100 millimeters. And now I'm going to move back 100 millimeters.
So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.